The Eyes of the World will be here in Edinburgh on the 31st of December for Hogmanay and the countdown to the bells at midnight. Hogmanay is a really big deal up here, but not so much in the rest of Britain. The party itself in the gardens is mostly for the tourists, but pretty much everybody in the country will be watching the countdown to the bells at home or with friends. Hogmanay dates back to the 16th century. It comes from the medieval French word aguilina, meaning a New Year's gift. And this might relate to the practice today of first footing and bringing a gift to the house of friends or family at midnight. But it really takes off following William of Orange taking the throne in 1688, when the Kirk in Scotland tried to ban the Christmas festivities as idolatry. But of course it's dark and cold for a long time here at winter, and there wasn't much to do for farming people, so the revelries were simply transferred over to Hogmanay. And then through the Scottish Enlightenment period, Hogmanay gathers more speed, because along with Burns Night it becomes a part of the establishment of a distinctly Scottish identity. But for me as a scholar of religion, what's very interesting about Hogmanay is that it has no connections to any religious tradition, but nonetheless it can tell us a little bit about how religious rituals work. For Emile Durkheim, one of the founding figures of sociology, writing a little over a century ago, the elementary form of religion was the rituals that communities use to bind themselves together and project out their ideals. Now, seen in this light, Hogmanay would be a religious ritual. In it, the Scottish people take part in a ritual together. The normal rules of society are set aside for a short period of time in order to project out positive ideals of resilience, good cheer, and creativity out to the world. Sláinte.